Welcome to Toffee TV. It is the Everton News Daily. It's Thursday, the 4th of August 2016. Still not really much news knocking about, if we're totally honest. Is that today, the stuff I'm going to talk about is a potential up in the bid for Ashley Williams. Conor Grant has joined Ipswich Town on loan. And are we about to make a bid for another Belgian striker? Let's start with Conor Grant, because that's the only firm bit of news that we have today, of course. Conor has gone out on loan to Ipswich Town for the season. Just signed a new two-year deal with Everton a couple of weeks ago. His contract, he was out of contract on the 30th of June. Ronald Koeman came in and took him to Austria and has given him a two-year deal, so he's obviously seen something. Missed the penalty, of course, in the Dresden Cup. That's why you're being sent out on loan, Conor. Now, he looked okay when he came on against Betis last week. He had probably our best effort on goal in that game from about 25 yards. So he's got a nice left foot. He'd done well at Doncaster last season, of course, on loan. Scored quite a few goals for them. He's also been up at Motherwell as well. So building his experience in league football. And I think he'll do really well for Ipswich Town. He'll be good in the Championship. Obviously, Joe Royal will watch him again this season and report back to Ronald Koeman, and we see where we go from there. But just going to wish him all the best. So all the best, Conor, whether you're watching this video or not, I'm not quite sure. Let's move on to speculation, because that is basically all that is happening daily at Everton. Although we have, of course, signed a player this week already in Adrisha Guy. Speculation today, or probably more fact, I would say, than speculation, that Everton are going to go back in with an improved offer for Ashley Williams, the Swansea and Welsh captain. Got to. I think we've got to have another go at it. I think the position Swansea are in at the moment, they don't want to lose their captain so close to the season. I think Ashley Williams has told Swansea exactly what he wants to do. I think he's told him he wants to join Everton. And they probably are going to try and force him to potentially put a transfer request in to save a little bit of face, maybe take another million or two off Everton in the process. But I think it's important that Everton try and get this done. Steve Walsh working on that deal as we speak. I think it's important that we try and get this tied up within the next 24 hours. Get him here, get him signed, get a week's training behind him before the season opener, of course, against Spurs at the weekend. My little lad doesn't know the meaning of be quiet for a minute. Another player we have moved on. Let me know what you think about Williams. Should we just call it quits because he's going to be 32 in a few weeks, or do we go for him? Because I personally believe we haven't got anyone like him. It's a little bit like when we got Sylvain Distan and came here at 31 and was a great servant for a few years. I think Williams could come here and just, it's all about getting up those next levels, isn't it? It's not about saying, yeah, but he's not going to be the captain for 10 years or for 5-6 years. We know that, but we need to recover from 2 years of mismanagement, in my opinion. And I think Williams will help us do that. So that's my opinion. What's yours? Do we go with it or should we walk away now? Let me know what you think in the comments section below. Another story, speculation. I'm not even going to touch on Julian Draxler. Yes, I would have him all day long, but that to me is beyond the realms of possibility, until Everton show me otherwise. But one player I'm going to talk about is Christian Benteke, the Liverpool striker, of course, Belgian forward. He has been linked heavily with a move away from Anfield this summer. Crystal Palace had a £32 million bid accepted for him a couple of weeks ago. He's still a Liverpool player, so it shows you that he doesn't want to go to Palace. And Everton have been linked with him. He's now being touted between Everton and Sunderland now. A lot of people will say no immediately. Personally, I would take him. I think Liverpool haven't got a tune out of him. I still think he would do a decent job for Everton. I think we get the right service into him, he could do well. Personally, I'd love to get him and to come here and to be brilliant, just because they couldn't get him playing. That'd be boss. But if Romelu Lukaku is to leave, and I'm not saying he will, you know, if he was to go, you start looking around at who could come in and score goals. You can quote, I was talking about Lacazette the other day, but it doesn't look like Arsenal can get him out of Lyon. So how would we get him? You know, it's one of them, isn't it, with him? And then it's who you get who will score your goals. Lukaku, first touch is is woeful. He can control a ball further than I can probably kick it. But he gets your goals, and goals are so difficult to replace. There he is again. So difficult to replace. And Benteke has scored in the Premier League, hasn't he? He scored a lot of goals in the Premier League. I think his ratio is still 1-2 in England. I think Boney's another one we could potentially get. We could potentially get the both of them with the money being bandied around, and obviously the stuff that, you know, they want John Stones, Man City want John Stones and everything else. So, Zach, would you buy Benteke from Liverpool?
Yeah,
okay, that's good enough for me. So, let me know what you think in the comments section below. If Lukaku goes, should we buy Benteke? He thinks so. Let's see what happens anyway. Okay, let me know what you think in the comment section below. Give us a like on Facebook. Give us a follow on Twitter. It's time for me to go. I'll see you soon on Toffee TV. Give the camera a wave. Give the wave. Bye. No one like one-handed. One-handed. Smile.